Hello children, I hope you have prepared well for your unit test. Now as a science sponsor, we are going to see revision for science examination. And you know that you will write the science exam for 30 marks, of which it is divided as 10+10, each for physics, chemistry and biology. Right? So in that, for physics 10 marks, we will have 5 short answers in which each question will take 10 marks. Okay, so before getting into the content-based revision, I want to give you some tips towards your examination, right? So when you are writing, right, so some points you need to note in your mind, okay? First thing, you have to be very clear in your content, right? So need not to memorize all the content line by line without even reading is and was and what. First, understand the concepts. Then, for the correct active, have some basic memorization, right? Don't go deep into the memorization without understanding. So understanding first, then go with your deep learning, right? So first, content, quality of your content is important in your paper, right? Next one is, when you are writing personal details in your paper, right? So when your paper is like this, right? So I will explain it. So now, when your paper is like this, usually our school children will have the practice, right? To write all your personal details, full personal details throughout the first page, right? Kindly don't write like that, don't waste one full page for that, right? And also, when you're writing the details here, write that in your right corner row. Write your name, class, subject, date, and your parent's signature. This alone is important. Don't write a school name at all. You know very well know that you came from the school, right? So write the needed details in a very presentable way, and we need some special space here to enter our marks, right? So that when we fold the paper will be uniform, so that our time will not be consumed unnecessarily. Okay? So that is what your second point. And when you are writing the content, highlight your headings, topics, subheadings, either by underlining it or by writing it in black, right? So main point, important point, subheadings, all those about should be highlighted. And after each question, draw a line. Okay? Question and answer, right? So write in ink pen. So don't use ballpoint pens. And this is the next one. Attend all the questions. As you are going to write only 5 short answers, right? So don't leave any questions, attend all the questions. Attend in the sense correctly, so that you have to learn very properly. So don't leave any questions, right? So usually you are most often even the sentence scorers will have spelling mistakes in your paper. So that may reduce your 1 mark or half mark, which may lose your sentence too. So when you are having doubts on your spelling, go with writing practice of your hard words, so that you can get clear with your spelling. So avoid bad spellings. So these are the points I wish to tell you right now. As far as revision is concerned, right? So what are the main areas you need to concentrate here? Right? First, you have to go categorize the questions, right? So that your revision process will be easy. As you are going to learn 2 lessons, right? So now here, definitions you need to learn, sums, flowcharts and graphs, laws, formulas and units, and equations, right? So these are the main areas for which you have to concentrate more, right? So here, first one, definition is mechanics, right? So mechanics, what is mechanics? It is the branch of physics which deals about the state of a body. State may be in rest or motion or uniform motion, right? So that is your mechanics. And when you are learning one particular definition, have its branch learning also. How mechanics is divided, what are its classification, statics, dynamics, what is statics, what is dynamics, that enough have a rough learning, right? Next one is scalar quantities and vector quantities. What are scalar quantities? I told you, do you remember this word? Magnitude. So most of you have forgotten it. What is magnitude? The numerical value. I have told you this example. When you have temperature of, what is that? 102 degree, right? So that 102, you are saying, that number. Class of 50 students. that 50 you are saying no, that is called magnitude, numerical value of quantity, right? If a quantity has magnitude alone, if you can assign one number alone for a quantity, then that particular quantity is called scalar quantity. And if a quantity changes with the direction also along those magnitude, like displacement, I told you, know, you remember distance and displacement, whatever way we travel that comes under distance, but in that distance the shortest distance is called displacement. So if a quantity varies with the direction also, then it is vector quantity. So confirm the definition, quantities having magnitude only are called scalar quantities. Quantities having both magnitude and direction are called vector quantities. Here, in question, even if it is not asked, right, you are supposed to write example, right? So don't forget to write the examples. And if example is not written, half a mark will be reduced. Then don't ask. It is not asked in the question mark, why half mark is reduced? Whether it is asked or not, for quantities, if it is example, if there are examples, you have to write it, okay? Whether it is asked or not, right? So go with your definition and at least one example, right? So scalar you can write distance, this vector you can write displacement, very simple, right? So then we have distance and displacement. Just now I told you that definition, the length covered by an object if it moves from one point to another, right? Then it is called as distance. And when you are writing these quantities, while taking classes, if I told you definition, what are the other two quantities you need to write? Formula, unit, three must be there, right? Out of 2 marks, 1 mark for definition, 1 mark, half a mark for formula, half a mark for unit. This is how 2 marks will be given. It will not be asked, there is a question. Question may be like define distance. I don't think that only the statement alone you are supposed to write, right? If it is like that, 1 mark only I will give, right? So distance, displacement, the length covered by an object is called distance, and the shortest distance is called as displacement. For these two, we don't have any formula, right? So unit alone is there. Unit alone means the definition will take 1.5 mark, unit will take 0.5 mark. What is this unit? Meter, okay? Right. Similarly, here speed and velocity, and not the story what we have learned here, that don't come here. Here speed and velocity have units. What is speed? The rate of change of distance is called speed. What is its formula? Speed S is equal to, what is that? Distance by time. S is equal to d by t. Unit, meter per second. Ms power minus 1. When you are writing only, you have to write ms power minus 1. While you are reading it, don't read it as ms power minus 1. Read it as meter per second. Okay? Right. Velocity, rate of change of displacement. See how I have written? Distance goes for speed, displacement goes for velocity. So pair it up and learn. It will be easy for you to learn. Right? Velocity is rate of change of displacement is called velocity. What is the formula? V is equal to small s by t. Remember, capital S goes for speed. Displacement, it will have small s. So don't have confusion. See children, some children will make big jokes in the paper. This is capital S ma'am. This is small s ma'am. Please don't do like that children. Have some differentiation in your writing. So have this as capital S to have a differentiation. This may be small s, but to differentiate it, write like this. So it will be clearly seen, right? So the speed means this s you use, displacement means this s you use, right? So it will not create confusion in you. Yes, of course, it may be similar for both capital letters and small letters. So avoid confusion, right? Next one is acceleration. Okay, I have forgotten this unit. What is this unit? Meter per second. Ms power minus 1, right? Next one is acceleration. Rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Symbol A. Children, when you are writing this symbol, don't waste your time writing one particular line. You will write the heading, no, subheading. When the question is asked, define acceleration, you will start the question with the subheading acceleration. There itself you write small a, right? So it is automatically understood. So don't waste time. symbol or acceleration is A. Don't waste the time. There itself you write. Okay? So, but I like it. Right. Acceleration symbol is A. A is equal to V by T. Unit is meter per second square. M is power minus 2. Right. Acceleration due to gravity. Heading. Symbol G. Small g. What is its unit? The force with which Earth is attracting every object. The clear technical definition I would have given in your notes. Go with it. This is the conceptual definition. Right? So that the acceleration with which every particle is accelerated by the force given by the Earth is called as acceleration due to gravity. Here you have to write the value also. G is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. This value is very very important. Formula need not to write formula as a your class is concerned. In your higher classes it's okay. What is its unit? Meter per second square. Why? Because it is acceleration. Okay. Next coming to this speed we have sums here. In that part 3 sums and part 5 sums. In mechanics you can scroll back to your videos based on speed, right? Distance and time will be given, and displacement and time will be given, speed will be calculated, velocity will be calculated, and distance and speed will be given, time will be asked. So in these factors, speed, distance, time, velocity, displacement, time, so any two factors will be given, the other will be asked. So very simple. Simple sums, based on the sums, what we have done in the problem. Ultimately, we would have done 20 sums, right? Yes? So, one part I had done 7 sums, and other part I had done 5 sums, and again I had done 7 sums, right? So, in that, concentrate more on part 3 videos and part 5 videos. So, ultimately, it will come around what? 10 sums, right? So, practice all those sums, and don't expect the same numbers in the examination too. Right, model alone will be the same, numbers will be changed. Right? So next one is momentum. Momentum, what is momentum? Simple, small p. It is the product of mass and velocity. P is equal to mv. Unit is what? Kilogram meter per second or newton seconds. Any one unit, if you forget one, we leave it, no problem. Any one unit you need to remember. Whichever is easy for you. Don't you need not to memorize. P is equal to mv. No. What is m? Mass. What is its unit? Kilogram. Next one is b. Velocity. What is its unit? Meter per second. So without even memorizing, you can write kilogram meter per second. Next one is inertia. What is inertia? Inability of a body to change from one state to another. What are these three types? Need not write these types, children, but to have a very good impression on your paper that you have learned well, right? So you can write these three steps, right? Extra attention will be collected by the teacher. So good impression you will get. Next one is impulse. What is impulse? Its symbol is J, capital J. I hope you remember. It is the big force acting for a short time. If you forgot this definition, most of them. Don't worry at all. Just memorize the formula. What is the formula? J is equal to F into T. I am going to write that formula. I have written here F. Just write. Say, change that formula into the sentence. Impulse is the product of, for example, I have written here. Impulse is the product of force and time. Simple. Finish the definition. Write unit. What is that? Newton second. Or kilogram meter per second. Right, next one is, so all these definitions are very important, concentrate more on this. Okay, next one we have loss, not LOSS, it is LAWS, be very clear with your study. Right, we have three laws of motion, and so this statement, we can be asked in any way. Right, state Newton's law of motion, state Newton's law, state the laws of motion. The words may be confusing, don't think that Newton's law only man taught, law of motion man will teach what to do. Both are same. Right? So be very clear with this. It can be asked in two ways, law of motion, Newton laws. Okay? So all the three laws statement, when you are writing these laws, children, you have to be very careful. As it is in the book, you are supposed to write. Right? Because it was stated by some scientist, okay, we don't have any right to interfere or modify the statement. So as centers we gave in the notes, replicated in your examination without even, here you have to show your memorizing ability, here only, right? So all the three statements, first law, second law, third law, right? So memorize it, write and practice, write the laws with the colon, with the double quotation, because someone stated it, right? So write like that. On the top of it, Newton's first law states that line should come, okay? So then in that, second law will have an equation. Do you remember what is it? F is equal to ma, force is equal to mass. That equation must be there, right? That will give you 1.5 marks for the statement, okay? And third law, we have one another equation, fa minus fb. I hope you are learning the pages of your notes. Yes, right. Fa minus fb. So that equation you need to write. Okay, next one, law of conservation of momentum. What is it? Initial momentum is equal to final momentum. So that statement along with that equation. Okay, now we have come to flow charts. What are the flow charts we have? We have flow charts for mechanics, classification of mechanics, and for motion also we have. Right, what are the types of motion? So that flow charts we need to prepare well. Next we have graphs for uniform motion, rest and non-uniform, three graphs we have. So that practice is, right? So they're all diagram based questions, very important. And we have equations of motion. We have four sets of equation motion, right? V is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, v square is equal to u square plus 2gs. This equation is modified under four conditions, right? So negative acceleration, moving up, moving down. So all these equations you need to be very clear, very simple, no? So practice that. Then we have these formulas. What are they? Formulas, if you know, definitions you can write, units you can write. So everything will be easy if you memorize these formulas. So formula, law. So here only you need to show your memorizing ability. All others will go for your understanding. That F is equal to ma, V is equal to S by T, S is equal to D by T, A is equal to B by T, momentum B is equal to mv, impulse J is equal to F into T. Right? So we have some points need to be concise way you have to write what are the units. So here three people will make so many mistakes. Right? So for distance and displacement, unit is meter. For speed and velocity, unit is meter per second, acceleration meter per second square, force you have newton, impulse and momentum you have similar units kilogram meter per second and newton second. Right? So along with that for time you have second. So children, so we have covered the entire three lessons, the main concepts. First finish these concepts and go to the other leftover concepts. Learn well, do well. Thank you children.